my name is Dr. Wei Shen Lai, the CEO of Acoustic Sheep. I'm going to go over masks and gloves and how to wear a lab coat and how to take them all off when you're done. So first of all, masks have to be comfortable. If they're not comfortable, then you're going to be adjusting them all the time. And touching your face is exactly what we don't want you to do. So before you put your glasses on, what you'll need to do, make sure it fits snugly. Mine has a nose wire, and I think that's very, very important, or else you're going to get a big gap in that area, and viruses and other contaminants can get in through there. So you want to seal up that hole. And I have here 3M micropore tape. This is my favorite for this type of thing, for this purpose. It's a paper tape. And so it's pretty gentle on the skin when you go to take it off. All right, so now that it's well adjusted on my nose, I cover up just a little bit and I do that. I just press it down. This is what I did during surgery when I was on rotations as a medical student and as a resident. And that way it just kept it on and would not need to be adjusted over time while you're doing a surgery for hours and hours. And that way, like, say this one comes loose against the bottom. And I just want to point out that I have ties. So this one goes to the top of my head and this one goes under my hair. The bottom tie goes under my hair. And so that way I can move around freely. And the tie that's on top does not like sit across my ears and just kind of bug them all day. So, but anyway, if this comes loose, at least this stays on, and that occasionally happens. So, all right, especially when you're making your own face mask, that may not be ideal. So this is kind of what it looks like when you take it off. This is my homemade face mask. All right, so that's how you wear a mask. And then what I've noticed as the CEO and I have some employees cleaning our location every day, basically, twice a day, actually, between shifts. One of the regulations in Pennsylvania is that they need to be wearing a gown, but there are no gowns whatsoever to be found. So the equivalent of a gown would ideally be open in the back, but even that is very, very hard to find, or you have to make it yourself. And so what I've decided is to get them all lab coats. So something long, so that if they're leaning against the surface while they're cleaning or something, you know, this area, their thighs are all protected. And really it's fairly low risk. This is most important if they happen to have to clean after somebody who is suspected of having COVID-19 has left the area, and you seal the area for 24 hours as recommended, and then allowed it to air out, right, during that time, hopefully, and allow for all of the dust to settle in the room. COVID-19 has been found to linger in the air for more than 3 hours. And so over that time period, over 24 hours, it kind of, everything settles down. So even the micro particles of viruses that are in the air will settle and become deactivated over time. Honestly, they dry out, they just kind of die. And so anyway, so after you've let all of that happen, then you can go in and clean it yourselves. You don't have to pay like an outside company or anything like that to do it for you. Honestly, it is just pretty self-explanatory routine cleaning with cleaning products. Regular cleaning products that says it will kill viruses and all that kind of stuff, or even bleach, the loop bleach, will be enough to kill this virus. So anyway, here I've got on my long lab coat. And they're very cheap. I just bought some for my employees. They are $13 a piece. Today is like Nurses Day, and so there was like a 40% discount, buy one, get one, 40% off type of a thing, so it was great. Anyway, all right, so here I've got my gloves on. Imagine that I've just finished cleaning everything. Now I have to, and of course I was wearing a mask the whole time. That's very, very important, especially when you're vacuuming and moving air, okay? And so now you finished cleaning, you gotta take all this stuff off. First, you take off your lab coat, okay? Not your gloves, not your mask. The mask is the last thing to come off. All right, so here you take off your lab coat. And the reason why you want something like this as opposed to something like this is because you don't have to pull this over your head to remove it, okay? So this is something that once you've unbuttoned, you can just kind of take it off, and all of the contamination is on the outside. So on this side, on the inside, everything is clean. On the outside, you can assume that it's dirty. Now, is it really all that important? When it comes down to it, probably not. You don't have to be like paranoid about what's inside, what's outside. But if there was an actual case, then this is like the best protocol, okay? So here, you just kind of remove it, turning it inside out, and then you can take this, put it into a plastic bag, take it home, open up the plastic bag inside out, and put it into the wash, right? Normal hot water wash and then a hot dryer will kill everything. So just normal, you know, detergent, you don't have to have anything special. And as far as the dryer goes, that's actually more important to make sure that's on high. That's what's really gonna kill whatever is living on this. Okay, so now this is in a plastic bag. You're gonna take it home and wash it. Now you've got your gloves, right? Your gloves are now pretty contaminated. Okay, so here we're going to take this off. You can usually like find a little flange right here on the inside. So you take your one hand, find that flange, pull it off like that. Okay, so it's inside out now. All right, and then you use this hand to kind of pull that to bundle up the first glove. So now it's inside the other glove, okay? And then you find the inside. Let's see if I could demonstrate this on video. So you find the inside of this glove, okay? And then you basically roll it inside out again, like that, okay? And so basically everything that's contaminated is inside of this glove now. You've got one glove in the other, and this can be just disposed of. And now you have to wash your hands. Always wash your hands after you remove your gloves, no matter what. Even, you know, in theory, there's no hole in the glove. There should be nothing on your hands if you removed it correctly and everything, but it's just standard practice. Now these are nice nitrile gloves, and I decided to use these on camera because you can actually see it. It works a lot better on camera. But what I've actually been using, you know, when you go to Subway, you know, they always have those cheap polypropylene gloves, these clear gloves that are way too big for anybody's hand, honestly. But this is what I've been using for the grocery store. And what I plan to have the people who are cleaning at our facility use as well. This is good enough. You don't need anything fancy like nitrile or vinyl or latex or anything like that. Those are medical gloves, and honestly, good luck finding some, right? But these are actually still available. These just kind of come in bulk packs of 100 each, 100 single gloves, so it would be 50 uses. 100 of them is like a little over $1, I think. So for 1,000 gloves, it's only like $12 or something like that. It's fairly inexpensive. And these are food service or janitorial use. And so you're not taking away from the personal protective equipment of all of the healthcare providers. All right, and these, honestly, you can just remove them in the same way, right? So find this, pull it inside out, bundle it up in the other hand, find the inside, and pull it out. And there we go, and just dispose of that. And then the last thing you do after you've washed your hands is then, so you go to the bathroom, wash your hands, or use hand sanitizer. Washing your hands is always better than hand sanitizers, but hand sanitizers are handy. You don't have to go to the bathroom, open doors, all that kind of stuff. So whichever works better for you. And then you would take off your glove or your mask after you've removed everything else, after you've washed your hands. And then with, as far as the mask goes, take it so that it's, you keep the dirty stuff on the outside, and you just remove it from your ears or untie it or something like that. And then after you either throw it away or put it along with your jacket for washing, then you can wash your hands again. Okay, hopefully that explains how you remove gloves, try to keep a person clean after they've cleaned a contaminated area, potentially contaminated area. And how I recommend wearing a mask. I love having this tape so that you don't have to go around adjusting the mask. You can actually find this on the sleepphones.com website. We decided to start carrying them because I wrote an article about how to make your own mask, something similar to this, with a nose wire. Not a lot of masks designs out there have a nose wire, but mine does. It uses speaker wire, and we actually sell that on our website too now because people are writing in saying, hey, you know, it's a great design, but I don't have all this stuff at home. And so we decided to stock a little bit of it and help people out. All right. Thank you for listening, and take care.